I hope you guys are having fun.
Yeah.
You know, laughter is the only thing you can get for free. And especially when clowns are here to perform. Sorry, comedian, sorry. That's how they call us in Africa, they say we are clowns. They don't know comedians. Look at this guy, he's been going around and around and around. He's looking at somebody else. I'm talking to him. Okay. That's the great man. Next on my list is Andrew Bannam.
Yeah, I mastered it. Anyway, so somebody was saying they had a melon shoved up their ass. That's piss compared to what's happening to somebody at parks. Apparently, they're going to be getting a Triax Volvo Levante shoved up their arse. I'll tell you more about it later, but anywho. Someone's knocking on my door. It's the bailiffs. I should have been paying my bills or set up a payment plan. Oh, Lordy Lord, I'm up the shit. Oh, yes, I am. So, there's one thing I don't like. The train toilet. And it always seems to be ScotRail. ScotRail, ScotRail, ScotRail. Anyway, I jump in the toilet and I've got it out. Obviously, you have to have your dick out to have a pish. So there it is. Right? And then I hear this. That's the door opening. Oh, fuck. There's three ways of reacting. You could get really angry and flap your dick at the guy and be raging and obstinate and everything, or laugh it off and scrap it off going, haha, we've got all the same thing. Or stage X. Stage X I only use when they're not going to move out the door threshold. Well, you've seen mine, so let me see yours. Craigslist M4N, they move faster than the train itself. They actually make the train look like a complete joke. But anyway, there's another thing I don't really like regarding toilets. Right, have you ever been in Central Station and there's like a bar just opposite where the 50p loos are?
Yeah.
Right? And I go in, go up to it, furthest end of a urinal, and I didn't really realise what was on the wall. But anyway, I had it out once again, you know, I love to have it out once in a while. And, you know, I had it out, and I'm not saying I'm vertically blessed or anything, but anyway, I'm starting pissing, and they've got the toilet so badly designed, when you're stunning at urinal, the hand dryer turns on, and it's like one of them Dyson fuckers. So, let's say, for instance, I'm pissing away, and then suddenly it blows up into my face. And that's the first time I've tried water sports. And anyway, it's like pushing one way and then almost hitting the other guy, and I'm sitting there going, this is rather awkward, this is what water sports is about. So I get a gulp full of fucking piss in my mouth, and it's so awkward, and then I'm pissing on someone else. So really, I haven't been there since about February this year. I'm too traumatised. Now, there's all sorts of types of mathematics out in the world, including stuff to do with angles, flanges. I love the flanges. But anyway, there's one type of mathematics I would say would most appeal to these social justice warrior people. What's its name? Trigonometry. Well, it sometimes gets a laugh, but hey-ho. Right. What is a dildo's favourite website? BuzzFeed. I don't know BuzzFeed, I've got a wee gripe with BuzzFeed. Right, do you see these mad BuzzFeed personality quizzes? Right? I think they're shite because they don't tell you any truth, there's nothing to prove what they're saying, and three people are just walking around with terms in their head they don't really know. And if you're really wanting a personality test, what you do is you go to a doctor and say, I would like to get referred to Arndale Mental Health Resource Centre in Drumchapel. And then you get referred there, and if you're crazy enough, you can actually get sent to Gartnavel Royal from work quizzes and ECT, which is electric shock therapy. So, you know, there's potentials everywhere. Right. Now, here's a little thing. Who loves first bus? Who loves first bus?
Oh, no.
Well, I've got to say, first bus provide more comedy than I. Right? First call is the discovery route. The discovery route by first bus. The only thing I've discovered on that bus is some geezer that gets on and asks if I want to buy his lump of hash off him for a fiver, which is excellent value in these days. And then there's another route called the pioneering spirit on first buses. The only pioneering or spirit, anything going on, is this guy gets on at Broxburn with a big 1L bottle of vodka, chucks all the way down during the journey, and by the time we get to Edinburgh Waverley, he literally decks it right off the bus. That's the only spirit that's going on there. But I like where he's going. Now, I look at Facebook in a very, very cynical way, as per usual, because I think Mark Zuckerberg's a kook. But anyway, there's a lot of profiles out there. Let's say the name is Joanna Lee, right? Joanna Lee works at full-time mum. Works everywhere. Full-time mum. I would say next Jeremy Kyle, please. And then you see a guy, John Lee. Legend at here. No, it's not legend at here, it's a full-time ball bag. Right. I do a lot of travelling and such like it through the months and the years, right? Now, I was sitting on this coach ready to go to Manchester, and one driver says to the other, I'm not naming the company in case I get butt-whipped anyway, but anyway, one says, I fucking hate these new Levantes. And the other guy says, I fucking hate them at all. I'm going to send one straight up someone's arse. And I was like, I just seen the mental image of somebody booting a bus up somebody's arse. Bus going about 62 mile an hour because it's only capped at 62 mile an hour. But imagine that, 62 mile an hour, bus going up someone's jazzy. That's going to destroy somebody. Seriously, it's like, what the fuck? I mean, I know we've got our enemies out here, but fuck's sake, I mean, like, usually we kind of think, oh, I hope he gets food poisoning, or I hope he is busted for fraud, but a bus to destroy his arse? That's a bit serious. And it's like, whoa, and talking about something else, when I was down south, and there was this lassie says to another, and she was obviously talking rather disparagingly about her friend, and she says, see her? He's got a fanny like London King's Cross. I know I'm into all sorts of weird kinks and deviances, but I've never sat at the fanny and seen trains coming out lassies' fannies. You know, I've been through very kinky scenarios, but no train's ever hit me. You know? So, I'm going to do a wee song for you. Okay. It's building up, I certainly know it's going to erupt, it's going to blow. I need to release, so let me please. I'll let him go. I let him go, I didn't fall through, but it got close. I let him go, I let him go, it made my ass cheeks ripple. I don't care what you have to say, but that was so good and it felt so tingly. So, that's me away, and I'll catch you later.